Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will be showcasing the different views in the .NET MAUI Scheduler control. These include the calendar, timeline, and agenda views. I will demonstrate the features of day and week views, which include flexible working days and hours, the number of visible days, customization of time text format, and the creation of special time regions. Additionally, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the month cell in the month view and the header in all views. I am using a getting started example application that has been pre-configured with the MAUI scheduler control and appointment details bound to it. If you want to know more about creating a MAUI app and configuring the MAUI scheduler to it, you can check the video linked in the YouTube card. Also, you can download the getting started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I launched the application on an Android emulator. Once it is loaded, you can see the day view is displayed. To showcase all the views in the scheduler, let me define the allowed views property and set it to an appropriate value. Then, set the default view to the week view. Once the scheduler is loaded, you can see that the week view displays 7 days. To switch to a different view, click the Allowed Views button and select a view. The day view loads a single day. Workweek view loads 5 working days. And month view loads a single month. Similar to these views, the scheduler also supports displaying these views in horizontal timeline mode, which are referred to as timeline views, like timeline day, timeline week, timeline workweek, and timeline month. The timeline views show all its appointments horizontally, as the scheduler time slots are displayed horizontally. The timeline day view displays a single day on a horizontal time axis. Timeline week view displays all the days of a week on a horizontal time axis. Timeline workweek view displays only the working days of a week on a horizontal time axis. And timeline month view shows appointments across all days of a month on a horizontal time axis, with each column representing a single day. Finally, the agenda view displays events or appointments in chronological order and groups them together. By default, the agenda view displays the current date. Now, I am going to show you how to customize day, week, workweek, and timeline views. For that, I will add the days view property with scheduler days view and the timeline view property with the scheduler timeline view. The scheduler automatically adjusts the visible days based on the selected view type. For example, the day and timeline day view show 1 day, the week and timeline week view show 7 days, and the workweek and timeline workweek view show 5 days, taking into account non-working days. By default, the visible days are determined automatically. Set the number of visible days property to 3 for both views. Look here, only 3 days are loaded in the week view. When I switch to the timeline week, you can see similar changes. Next, I will demonstrate how to customize time interval and adjust its size in both days and timeline views. By default, the time interval is set to 1 hour. To modify it to 2, define the time interval property and assign values to it in both views. Then, the interval height is set to 50 by default. To change it, specify the time interval height property in the day view and set it to 100. Similarly, the interval width is set to 50 by default. To change it, specify the time interval width property in the timeline view and set it to 100. Before running the application, remove the number of visible days code in both views. Observe the result. In the week view, the time interval changed to 2 hours, and its height to 100. Switch to the timeline week view. See here the interval changed to 2 hours and its width to 100 in the timeline view. Next, I will show you how to set flexible working days and hours. Note that flexible working days are only available in the workweek view, whereas flexible working hours are available in all views. By default, Saturday and Sunday are non-working days in the workweek view. If I want to make Sunday only a non-working day and establish working hours from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., to achieve this, remove the time interval and its size customization code in both views. Then, define the non-working days property and set it to Sunday. To change the working hours, simply define the start hour as 9 and the end hour as 16. Apply these changes in the timeline view as well. Once the application is launched, observe the updated working hours in the week view. To view the working days, switch to the workweek view. In the workweek view, Saturday will be included as a working day while Sunday will be considered a non-working day. These changes will also be reflected in the timeline views. Now, let's see how to customize the time ruler size and its text format. By default, the time ruler width is 60 and its height is 30. To adjust the ruler size in the day view, define the time ruler width property and set it to 100, and in the timeline view, set the time ruler height to 60. The default time ruler text format is hour, minutes, and period of the day. To change the time ruler text format, define the time format property and set it to hours and minutes, and do the same in the timeline view. Before running the application, remove the flexible working days and hours code. Look at the week view. The size and the text format of the time ruler are customized. Switch to the timeline week view to see similar changes. Next, I will show you how to create special time regions to highlight working and non-working hours. For example, I want to highlight the time region between 13 to 14 as a lunch break. To do this, navigate to the main page constructor. Here, create a new variable called timeRegions to store a collection of instances of the SchedulerTimeRegion class. Then, create a new variable for the SchedulerTimeRegion to highlight a specific region by setting the startTime and endTime properties. To display text in the special region, set the text property to lunch, and to disable pointer interaction, set enable pointer interaction to false. To display a special region for each day, define the recurrence rule and set it to an appropriate value. Next, add the time region to the time regions collection. Then assign this collection to the time regions property of the days and timeline views in the scheduler. You'll notice a special time region highlighted in the day view, indicating the lunch break. Take a look at the timeline, where the lunch break is clearly highlighted. Next, I will show you how to customize the day and timeline views headers appearance. To do this, remove the existing codes in the days, timeline views, and constructor. Then add the view header settings property with the scheduler view header settings inside the scheduler days view element. Next, set the date format property to the date. Height to 100, and background to gray. Follow the same steps for the timeline view. Once loaded, you will notice the header date format, height, and background are customized in the week view. Switch to the timeline week view and see similar changes. Let's move on to the month view customization. By default, the month view displays appointment details in text format. But I want to display only the indicators. To do that, I define the month view using the scheduler month view element. Then, define the appointment display mode property and set its value to indicator. Change the view to month to set it as the default view. Before running the application, Remove the days and timeline views codes. You can see the indicator is shown in the appointment dates. Following that, I'll demonstrate how to hide the previous and next month's dates from the month view. For that, set the show letting in trailing dates property to false. Look here, the previous and next month's dates are not visible. Now, I show you how to customize the number of weeks visible in the month view. To do that, remove the previous code changes, then define the number of visible weeks property, and set it to 2. Once loaded, you can only see 2 weeks displayed in the month view. Next, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the month view header. Here, I remove the number of visible weeks property and add the view header settings property with the scheduler view header settings component. To change the height, set it to 20. To change the background, set the background property to yellow. Now, you can see that the height and background color of the month view header has been customized. Next, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the month cell. To do this, define the content page resources. To customize the text for the current month, add a single scheduler text style in the resources. Set a key name to it, and customize its font size and font attributes as desired. To customize the leading and trailing month text, I similarly add 2 scheduler text styles and customize their font size, font attributes, and text color. Next, to customize the appearance of the month cells, add a scheduler month cell style to the resources and assign it a key name. Within this style, you can set the background colors for the current, leading, and trailing months to appropriate values, giving them a distinct look. Then assign the respective text styles to the current, leading, and trailing month text using the assigned key names. Next, define the month cell style in the month view and assign the month cell style resource to it. Look here, the appearance of previous, current, and next month's dates appearance are customized. Let's move on to the agenda view customization. I set the view to agenda and remove the month view customization codes. Now, I show you how to customize the appearance of the month, week, and day headers in the agenda view. Here, define the agenda view with the scheduler agenda view. Now, to customize the month header's appearance, add the month header settings property with the scheduler month header settings. Next, to change the date format, set the date format to shorten month name with year, height to 50, and background to dark red. Next, to change the week header's appearance, add week header settings with the scheduler week header settings. To change the date format here, set the date format to month with shortened day name, height to 30, and background to yellow. Finally, to change the day header appearance, add day header settings with the scheduler day header settings. Then, to change the background, set the background to deep sky blue. Once loaded, you can see all the headers in the agenda view are customized. In this video, you learned how to customize the appearance of the scheduler views, including day, week, month, timeline, and agenda. I showed you some important features, such as choosing flexible workdays and hours, the number of visible days, customization of the time ruler text format, and the creation of special time regions in the day and timeline views. You also saw how to adjust the number of weeks visible and customize the month cell appearance in the month view. Additionally, you learned how to customize the header for all the views. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.